First and foremost, thank you so much for this beautiful opportunity that Ariel, you and all our friends put together. I'm so delighted to see all our women's friends or sisters, I call them, that they were all there, and I was so fascinated to listen to all. And now, maybe it's better that you all ask me question, if in case you all have something, then I could answer that. Or, there's so much going on in India right now, and actually I am very, practically really very busy in the field, reaching out to people in whatever way I can. Not I mean as an organization, that we are trying to reach out to people, especially to the women, whoever is in need. Not only that, we are reaching out to the families. So while reaching out to the families, if the women are having any problem, because of the lockdown, the women are really, really suffering in India, many of them. Because of the lockdown, the men are in the house, some of them are, and the, now the the wine shops are open, and our men really don't know how to drink. They're harassing and things like that. So at this time, I'm trying to be to do what kind of service that I can offer to the people. And we see that domestic violence have gone quite high during this time. Just today I was reading that, just came to know that through one of my friends, that one woman, she killed her three children, she hanged her children and hanged herself. And the reason was that it was written that she was hungry and she couldn't bear to see the children hungry. So these are the things that we are hearing every day. And at the same time, you know, to be normal, to be cheerful, not to give in to depression. It's so easy when we read and go through such, you know, stories or things that we hear. How to be still find that peace within you and to keep spreading that love and peace. That was the challenge before us. And especially when we get phone calls after phone calls saying that this is happening, we don't know how to handle this, and you have to come here, we can't go there because it is we cannot travel. And at the same time, how to reach out with our heart to the people. So these are the few challenges that we've been facing, and you can ask me any question that within the limited way of doing that, I know all that what we do. Is just a drop in that ocean of problems that we are seeing with the for women, and also not only women, the families. So I am free. You are free to ask me anything, that whatever way I can answer you.
Well, again, I invite everyone to, if you have a question for Sister Lucy, to enter it into the chat. I have a question for you, Sister Lucy, to kick this off. I have had the honor to meet probably six of the children who have grown up in Maher. And despite all the hardships that they have been through, they are some of the most joyous people I have ever met. They just have joy and love and that radiate from their being. And I think I attribute that to their experience of being raised in Maher. But I'm wondering if you have any insights or thoughts to share about that joy that the children at Maher seem to learn from you.
Actually, they give me more back than what I've been offering. When we come to, when it comes to that motherhood, you know, it's automatically, I think there's some kind of a different energy that is coming out. And that must be helping our children to be what they are today.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sister Lucy. I don't see that anyone has entered a chat, but I would welcome anyone to also unmute yourself and either give Sister Lucy a comment or a reflection or a question.
Anyway, I'm so glad to see my friends, Essa, Evelyn, and Susan. Thank you for being here. Margarita, I can't see your face.
May I also speak something? Because I don't know how to use the chat here. I don't know how to do that. Hello, Lucy. Love from Germany.
I know. Thank you. So glad to see you.
Same here. Well, I wanted to ask if in Maher all the children have to sit in their homes, or are you still in lockdown, or are the gates open?
No. It is still under lockdown till the 31st of May. It's quite a long time to keep them inside. And, you know, when the children cannot go to school, they have not much to do. And then to keep them inside the room locked up, it's so really, really, it's a challenge. But, you know, somehow because they have companions to fight and to talk and to make fun and to have fun, they somehow manage the time. Then we have TV, they have study time. They have a lot of activities which we have planned for throughout the day. So, and that's how they manage, because the social workers are busy organizing many things for them, new things, and they get fed up of the old games. So we have to break our head to find new games and how we can keep them busy. So this is what we are doing.
Fine.
And then of course, a lot of time we spend on meditation, prayer, and that is part of their life. Yeah.
But do you have any COVID cases yet, or?
So far within the houses, God has blessed us. Nobody is sick. All are okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Sister Lucy, I think I heard you say that you and the children have prayed for 24 hours.
Yes.
Does that, like, you prayed for 24 hours straight without?
No. Every house was given 1 hour slot. Okay, we have 49 homes. So every house was given 1 hour of slot. And that was that they had to pay attention to the female energy within them and asking and being in connection to the divine female energy to heal the world. That was the topic that was given to them. And I can say that it was done so beautifully. I could see all the pictures. You know, we have a group, and they could put the pictures, how they did and what they did. And it was so beautiful. It was so enlightening.
Beautiful. Yeah. Could I ask a question?
Yes, please, Susan.
Hi, Lucy, and hi, everybody in the group. Lovely to see you again. Lucy, I'm just wondering, say, in the context, I'm living in Ireland, and how does the feminine energy rise, say, within the church context, when it's so male-dominated?
Yes. It is male-dominated, you mean?
Yes.
That's every way. We have to go through that. That's part of our life, no? And yet to... Yeah, especially if you are in India, you'll feel so frustrated. You know, to come to that, it's a different language I'm talking. Even when I was talking to my staff about the female energy and paying attention to that, praying to that female energy, etc., they were wondering, what is that language I was talking, you know? And I said, yeah, the female energy has the energy to heal. We have to pay attention to that. Don't neglect that and things like that. So because we are so used to that male-dominated energy, you know, so it is almost looked down or it put down, you know, and we are not realizing that divine has both this energy, and we have to be there connected to both the energy. But we are so used to, you know, seeing the female energy. Naturally, all our priests are male. If every religion as much as now. So it's very difficult for us to get into that what is called a female energy, I mean, if we connect to the divine energy and say, okay, in the divine energy, both these aspects are there, but it was difficult, but something they must have been catching, you know, but I don't know what they were catching, but it was coming through, I can say.
Yeah.
Because yeah, all those, even the songs that day, which they have to sing, what we call the hymns, everything was, they were told to take only the songs that was meant for the female energy or female name.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I think we have about 7 or 8 more minutes. So if anyone else has a question, there's plenty of time to get it in while we have Sister Lucy with us. And if you hover over your picture where you see your face, you'll see the unmute button.
Lina, I'm so happy to see you.
Hi, Sister Lucy. It's Don McKenzie of the Interfaith Amigos from the U.S.
Yes, I met you, Nangda.
Nice to see you.
So nice to see you, yeah.
I just want to express my appreciation for this particular moment and to everyone who's been a part of this today. There's no question in my mind that patriarchy is sustained by the profound imbalance of feminine and masculine ways of understanding experience. And so I think my two colleagues and I are constantly trying to figure out how we shift from that unrestrained masculinity to that balance that is so deeply needed these days, especially. And our hope, of course, is that somehow the pandemic will give birth to something that will help us to find that balance. So if anybody has any guidance about how people can be helped with that, we'd be deeply grateful.
I don't know how to say, but you know, in India, especially in Hinduism, there's a lot of what we call to the female energy and what we call Durga Mata and so many other female goddesses that are there. Okay, but somehow, somewhere down the lane, I don't know how we got misled or we just somehow pushed back our female energy. And I'm so happy, Don answers that what you are thinking for the world. You know, it's so nice coming from a male voice that you are thinking. That encourages people like me to continue or trying to do what we think is most needed to bring out that female, what you call energy, bring forth for that, so that there should be some kind of balance in this world, and not that one should dominate the other, but on an go with an equal footing, you know, or I don't know how you can call it, in an equal way of going about. So that I know it is a difficult task before us, especially working in India, it is really, really difficult, but it's not impossible. When somewhere someone starts, you know, of course there will be some people telling you are absolutely crazy and things like that, but I feel the need to continue doing what we are convinced, what I'm convinced of. And that makes other people to join you when you're that's what I feel.
Thank you, Sister Lucy.
Thank you. Hello, Will.
So we have about 5 more minutes. And I invite anyone to unmute yourself and ask Sister Lucy a question or give a reflection or a comment. know we've had a couple great questions so far. So I don't know, Sister Lucy, if you have any final story to share with us, perhaps. You shared one in your intro.
Yeah, when I was talking about, no? What I wanted to say, we're coming to the feminine energy that we, maybe because I had the opportunity to be the director of a project, which is mainly meant for not only women, but mainly it is all women. So it becomes much more easier for me to exercise the female energy, I can call it. And even when we call in for prayer to the female energy, there was a blank look on the man and also on other things. What is that you mean? They couldn't understand there is an energy even called female energy. It's all new terms, a new language. And so they were, I could see the puzzle in their mind, in their faces. And then I said, I explained to them what it is previous day, especially to the male staff. And there was a small song that I took it, and that is, it was going like this, Om Shakti, Om Shakti. And then I call it Om, Sri Shakti Om. Sri Shakti means the women's energy. We worship the women, female energy within us and within the other. So that was the thing. And they couldn't understand, but of course they all sang with me, which was very beautiful. And then I had sent the words to other houses and to sing. So they also told me, Didi, we were a little bit confused about that female energy prayer. And I could see that struggle. And at the same time, some people saying, why not? We should also to pray to that female energy. I could see the discussion before and after, which was very beautiful. Because at the moment, we have almost 1,500 people living in our different homes. And some of them sent me private message saying that, can you explain a little more? And then I had to do that and things like that. So I felt it was almost such a successful prayer. Deep within me, I was very, very satisfied. But of course, it put a lot of questions in the others. And today, when our social workers were reading again the feminine spirituality, they said, Didi, you were talking this some days back. Now it is on the screen. How is that possible? Because these are the things that they are not heard of much. And praying to female energy, never. It was impossible to see a god as a female. Though in Hinduism so much of female goddesses are there, but somewhere we had forgotten all about it, and it all became male. So it's naturally, it is a real task before us to come back to that. And somewhere I feel good that these things are happening, at least during this corona time. I could bring out this energy to pray now, because they will pray to any energy to get healed of this virus now. So I said, female energy is the one which can heal, I said. Yeah, I think it's time for us to move. Thank you for being here. I'm so happy.
I love that's you. A great story. Love it.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
I hope to pray and meditate with you someday at Maher. Love you, Sister Lucy. Thank you for sharing your light and wisdom with us today.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.